Morning.
Good
morning. Welcome to St. Anne Catholic Church. If you have your cell phone with you, please make sure it's off or on silent before we begin our liturgy. If you have children aged 6 months to 4 years, our nursery is open and available for your convenience. Today's gospel will help set the tone for the coming weeks and months. Having placed our faith in the Messiah, we are told that we must take up our cross every day and follow him. Strengthened by the power of Christ's death and resurrection, which we celebrated fully over the recent Triduum and Easter seasons, let us pray today to accept willingly the crosses of this life that we may know the fullness of life in the world to come. Our celebrant for this Mass is Father Jake. Please stand and join in singing the opening song.
Join in singing number 540, Glory and Praise to Our God. Number 540.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, each day you call us to follow you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, each day you clothe us in yourself. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And Lord Jesus, each day you pour into our hearts a spirit of grace and petition. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. For those children participating in the Children's Liturgy of the Word, please come forward. Heavenly Father, pour out your grace upon these children and inspire them with the word from the sacred scriptures. Just help them to always fall more deep in love with the sacred scriptures. And may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Zechariah. Thus says the Lord, I will pour out on the house of David and on the inhabitants of Jerusalem a spirit of grace and petition, and they shall look on him whom they have pierced, and they shall mourn for him as one mourns for an only son, and they shall grieve over him as one grieves over a firstborn. On that day the mourning in Jerusalem shall be as great as the mourning of Hadad-Rimmon on the plain of Megiddo. On that day, there shall be opened to the house of David and to the inhabitants of Jerusalem a fountain to purify from sin and uncleanliness. The word of the Lord.
Your right hand upholds me. from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, through faith, you are all children of God in Christ Jesus. For all of you who were baptized into Christ have clothed yourselves with Christ. There is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither slave nor free person, there is not male or female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus. And if you belong to Christ, then you are Abraham's descendant, heirs according to the promise. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Chief priests and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then he said to all, "If anyone wishes to come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. Whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will save it." The Gospel of the Lord.
My brothers and sisters, praise be Jesus Christ. This is my last 10:30 Mass with you all, my last Sunday with you all, and so it's been an honor to be here for the last 3 years serving you all here at St. Anne's. It's been truly, truly a blessing, and I came over to the Vigil Mass, just kind of watching, saying hi to people as they're coming in, and As Father Martin started the Mass, I was just kind of sitting there in the back, just kind of looking at it, all the people, and I was like, wow, I'm going to miss being here. But just wanted to say I've been truly an honor, and it's really an honor to be able to celebrate this Mass on Father's Day. And it's who I am, I'm your spiritual father here, one of your spiritual fathers here, so it's an honor to celebrate this Mass with you all. And something that I think all fathers always need to do this always, and that is I'd like to take this opportunity to ask forgiveness for anybody here who I might have offended in my 3 years here, just out of ignorance or just no knowledge. It's never my intention. I've always been seeking to serve each and every one of you, but it's possible that something could have happened and just not knowing it. And so I'd like to just take this opportunity to anybody who I might have offended, just ask your forgiveness, because I want to leave here from St. Anne's with love and no animosity. But I'd like to start off this homily with a story that I heard our vocations director give Friday evening. It's a beautiful story. This past Friday evening, we had a seminarian dinner here, and a seminarian and a religious and priestly appreciation dinner. And so some of you, if you were there, will recognize the story. But I think it's so beautiful, and I think it kind of sets the stage for my homily. There was a father who very much loved his family, and he had a daughter about 5 years old or so, and he loved her very dearly, and he gave her a gift. And she opened the little box, and there was a pearl necklace in the box, and she couldn't believe it. It was beautiful. They weren't real pearls, they were fake pearls, but she loved it. She couldn't tell the difference, and she just loved it so much, and she would wear it all the time. Particularly would always put it on before she went to bed, because her dad would come and tuck her in the bed, kiss her goodnight, and say, "I love you." And she used to always wear it just for that occasion to remind him that she loved it, she really appreciated it. And so as she got older, the years went by, the father would come back, and every once in a while would come back and say, "Will you please give me back the pearls I gave you? I'd like them back." And she would kind of thought to herself, why does he want them back? He gave them to me. I love them, you know? And so she kind of said, "No, I'm hanging on to these. Because I love them. You gave them to me, and they mean so much to me." And so he said, "Okay." And he would come back every once in a while and ask her, "Can I please have my pearls back?" And she would say no. And actually, she started kind of getting a little angry, like, why is he doing this to me? But he kept doing it. He kept asking her. And then finally, when she reached adulthood, and finally, he asked her again. And she says, "Fine, take them back. Here they are." And he puts them in his pocket, and he pulls out another box, and he gives them to her. She opens them up, and they're real pearls this time, a real pearl necklace. And of course, she was just completely happy, filled with joy. And that's a great story because it goes with fatherhood, today being Father's Day. And that is, our Heavenly Father, many times, He gives us many gifts, many graces, many blessings in our lives. And we become content with the things we've received with our life, to the point where that's all we want to settle for. That's all we want. But our Heavenly Father wants to give us more. And so, are we willing to give back? Say, "Lord, I surrender my will, myself, my things to you." God wants us to do that. We can't be attached to this world, to the things of this world. We have to be willing to let go. If that young lady was willing to let go sooner, she would have received something much greater a lot earlier. That's a great lesson, I think, particularly for us fathers. I'm speaking to myself at the same time. I need to hear these words. Our Lord says in the gospel, "Who do you say that I am?" That's a question we need to ask ourselves. Who do you say that I am? God is saying that to us. Who do you say that I am? When you receive the Holy Eucharist and the priest says, "The body of Christ," Christ is saying, who do you say that I am? And by saying amen, we acknowledge that that's God. Do I really believe that? Or am I just content sitting in my home and just watching football? This homily is going to be a challenge, is a challenge to the fathers in this church. We need to be challenged, because I'm going to, speaking from experience, guys, we like to be challenged, but once we've reached certain goals, we're content. We don't necessarily need a whole lot to make us happy. And it's so easy to just be content with the things that we have and not really try anymore once we've reached certain goals. But it's so important that are we willing to die to ourselves and seek something greater? We have to be willing to do that. And so, the importance of that is, am I willing to die to myself to help my family get to heaven? Am I willing to always, each and every day, see to it that I'm helping my wife get to heaven? My children get to heaven? And wives, are you doing everything you can to encourage your husbands to do that, to challenge them? And then men, are you challenging each other? Iron sharpens iron. We have to be willing to hold each other somewhat accountable. Many times, guys, you know, when someone corrects us fraternally, we don't like it. But we have to be willing to die to ourselves, to give up, so that we can receive something greater. We have to do that. This world is very much in its state because men haven't stepped up to become real men. They aren't looking out for their daughters. They're not seeking to make sure that they are always striving to be pure, to be the women they're called to be. They're not encouraging their sons to model themselves after the great men that have gone before us, particularly St. Joseph, who is the patron saint of fathers. We have to challenge them, to teach them to be willing to die to themselves. We have to do that. We have to take on that role. You can only imagine what was going through St. Joseph's mind when he was asked to be the foster father of the Son of God. Talk about an incredible task to be given, and to be the husband of the Mother of God. What a huge task. But the Father in heaven chose him because he mirrors the Father. And so I encourage all fathers here to have a deep personal relationship with St. Joseph. Something that I strive to do each and every morning is say a prayer to St. Joseph when I get out of bed in the morning. St. Joseph, help me to be the man you're calling me to be the father you're calling me to be a man of God, a man of purity, a man of chastity, a man of prayer. And help me to resist the temptations that come at me today. Help me to be a man of virtue. That's a prayer I try to pray every day, and it helps me. It reminds me of who I am and who I am called to be. We have to be willing to die to ourselves. And we all have, I think, particular role models in our lives. guys that who have gone before us or people we might know have accomplished so many great things, great athletes, you know, people who, you know, particularly here, I'm always a big fan of those who serve in the military, of men and women who go through and just, who are willing to sacrifice so much. They are great role models. Are we willing to sacrifice the things that we don't necessarily need in order to achieve holiness, in order to lead our families to heaven? It's not an easy task to be a father in this world today. It's not easy. It's hard. And today we don't really have a whole lot of good examples anymore. So we have to step up and set the standard to be men of God. Men not afraid to die if necessary, as the Lord sets the example in the gospel. He's willing to die. He sets the standard as the ultimate man that we are called to be. Sacrifice. And so, my brothers and sisters, we need to always be praying for each other, encouraging each other, to not be afraid to challenge each other, to live holy lives, to learn the faith. Especially back in the old days, that's how men learned how to work. They learned under their fathers or did some type of apprenticeship. They learned how to work. We have to do the same thing. We have to teach our children the faith. We have to teach them. So that means we need to learn it ourselves. It's so important we are striving to do that. We have to learn so that we can pass on what we've been taught to them, so that they are always strong in their faith. And so, my brothers and sisters, ask yourselves the question, who do you say that I am? Jesus is asking that. Who do you say that I am? And I hope and pray that you will always say, Jesus Christ, my Lord and my Savior, my God, who I'm willing to give up everything, to give back, because he loves me so much, because he wants to give me everything. He wants to give me happiness in heaven. So give him back our lives. My brothers and sisters, may God be praised. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in
the Lord Jesus Christ,
the begotten Son of God,
born of the Father before all ages,
God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, who in all things were made. For us made and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified in the Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
All are one in Christ Jesus, so let us pray for the needs of all those.
For this community of faith, that we may be instruments of God's forgiveness and mercy to all who are burdened by brokenness, alienation, and sin. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who live without adequate food and shelter, that soon all their needs will be met. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our fathers, living and deceased, who have kissed away our hurts, who have calmed our fears, and who have fiercely protected us from harm, that they may be embraced and strengthened by our Lord, the ultimate Father. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who were wounded and for those who lost their lives in the Orlando terror attack, that tolerance will prevail and God's love and peace will bring an end to violence in our troubled world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the men and women who serve our country, especially those in war zones, that they will be protected from harm. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, especially Anna Hicks, that the abundant healing of God will return them to wholeness and good health. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Marie Antoinette Lavelle, Lane Graves, Shaju Kulagaru, that they will be welcomed into eternal joy with God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our prayers spoken and unspoken. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray also for an increase of the priesthood, religious life, and holy marriages. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, you have made us your heirs through our Lord Jesus Christ. Give us the grace to live up to our Christian name and grant these in our prayers we may through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please join in singing number 465, All Is Well With My Soul, number 465.
Oh,
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that, cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his Paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deeds by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works. For you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Thank you. the mystery of faith. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wonders, resurrection, and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognize in the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gregory John, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you. number 493.
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Those who are bringing communion to the sick or homebound, please come forward. May you bring the blessed sacrament to those who are sick, and this most holy sacrament bring to them healing of mind, body, and soul. And may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Please be seated. If you own your own business and would like to participate in St. Anne's Business Fair the weekend of July 9th and 10th, please register through our website. Click the Upcoming Events tab and then fill out the registration form. The Ladies Auxiliary of Columbus is holding their annual yard sale next Saturday, June 25th, from 7 a.m. until 12 noon in Visitation Hall. Bargain hunters can find everything from baby items and antiques to home furnishings, clothing, and sporting goods. All monies raised will help fund a scholarship for deserving students to attend St. Anne Pacelli Catholic School. St. Anne's outreach will be open before and after all masses this weekend to accept donations. The item of the month is shampoo. If you have borrowed any books from me, I'd like them back. So I know there's a few out there, so if you maybe you might have borrowed a book from me, if you don't mind returning it, just return to the office. I'll be there tomorrow. My last day, I'll be leaving Tuesday morning to head down to Dublin, so if you find it later on, just give it to the office and they'll send it to me. Thank you. I'd like to thank those who decorated our church with the Father's Day flowers, like the CCW, all those who helped put that on. It's beautiful, the church is beautiful to honor our fathers, those who are living and as well as deceased. So thank all those who helped put that on and make the church beautiful to honor our fathers. If I could have all fathers to please rise. God our Father, in your wisdom and love you made all things. Bless these men, that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Be merciful as your heavenly Father is merciful. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Before we go forth, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Father Jake for his ministry here at St. Anne's. Verses will send him forth to his next ministry. Number 382.